This is Sam.
Nigga hustling, I ripped off your poker palace.
Son of a bitch.
Crime just don't pay in Bucktown.
Cleet, you sure do enjoy your work.
Yeah, you got that right. Hey, you know, this is a real bad cat. He almost killed a couple of high rollers. You gonna be in town long?
Why, you the welcoming committee?
Hey, will you have a good time while you're here?
Better get his ass to the hospital.
Club Alabama is?
Yes. Son, do you believe in God?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Then you're in the wrong place.
Why didn't you tell me it was closed?
You didn't ask, did you? Place been closed since Ben died.
Where can I find a good hotel?
We ain't got one.
Well, how about one that changes sheets at least every other night?
That'd be the old Dixie. It's just a couple of blocks down. I'll take you.
Oh, thank you.
Color of her dream. And I'll show both of you the time you'll never forget.
I'll help you with it, mister. No charge. I'm glad to help. But if you want to tip me a half a buck, I'll tell you where to get your act together and where to get it on.
Oh, yeah? Get what on?
You name it, I got it.
No, thanks.
Okay, how about cards? If you go to Doc Anderson's, check the deuces and nines. They're marked.
Little man, I ain't interested.
Okay, women. The best in town is Sonora over at Ruby's. But don't let it get on top, because you'll buck your brains out.
Where do you get all this information from anyway, huh? You sell penicillin too?
Thanks, man. See Arnetta. She'll get you the best room in the house. And be sure and tell her Stevie sent you.
Is that yours?
Yeah, why?
Because you're the only pimp I ever seen that drives a motorbike.
Hey, I ain't no pimp. I'm Walt Disney. This is Disneyland.
Interested, I could turn you on to a whole lot of fun.
No, thanks.
Well, you know, it ain't my business, but what's a fine black thing like you doing in town?
I'm just here to bury my brother, that's all.
Whew.
Yeah?
A fella just checked in by the name of Johnson. Duke Johnson.
Did he say anything?
No, he didn't talk too much, but he said he's here for Ben's funeral.
I'm glad you called, Arnetta.
Well, you told me to check with you now. That's what I'm doing.
Night.
Yeah.
Your dinner's ready, Chief Patterson.
Almighty God in heaven above, I thank thee for what you've set before me, and I give
unto you, O Lord, the soul of this good man, this humble man, Ben Johnson, a man of the people, all peoples, who always held his hand out to help others, who gave like you and asked not in return. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He restoreth my soul. So we know, Almighty God, that you will continue to love Ben as we have loved him, to embrace him, to take him into your kingdom this day. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Those are good words, Reverend. Thank you.
Excuse me, sir. I'm Waldo Harlan. Might you be a friend of our beloved Ben there?
Yeah, I'm Duke Johnson.
Duke? That's just what I figured. Aretha, you and Stevie, say hello to the Duke. That's Ben's brother.
You really Duke?
Ben told us all about you. Says you're the smartest one in the family. You know how you've been all over the world and everything.
So you're the one. When was the last time you saw Ben? 5 years ago?
No, it was more like six.
Some hotshot brother.
Aretha, please.
Where were you when he needed your help?
What kind of help?
There's nothing you can do about it now, except for to find the time to come and bury him and collect your stuff and split.
Aretha, now, you gotta get yourself.
Aren't you gonna stay? No, he's not gonna stay. He wouldn't dirty that shoe shine in his cow pasture, would you, Mr. Duke Johnson?
Aretha, please. Don't mind the Duke. Ben was good to her. His dying kind of put a pain of grief into her. Don't mind her.
No, I can't mind a lady that speaks her mind.
That's right, Duke. Duke, you're absolutely right.
according to this will, left everything to you. An estate consisting mainly of a lot and frame house, a hand tool leather wallet containing $39.43, and a savings account passbook in the name of Benjamin A. Johnson.
Okay, now all of Ben's things belong to me now, right? To sell, use, anything I want, right?
In about 60 days.
60 days? Man, you gotta be kidding.
That's the state law. Takes that long to close an estate.
What am I supposed to do? Stick around this rat trap for 2 months?
Of course we could relax the rules a bit. Allow you the use of your brother's properties.
Huh. How much?
Let's say you sign for an empty hand tool leather wallet.
You run a nice business around here, don't you?
I do. I've been over there waiting for you. Tell Stevie all about it.
Yeah, about what?
Oh, how you gonna stay on, open the club and everything? Man, I can't wait for them good times to start rolling again. Place is really like a home to some of us, you know, especially Stevie here, because he lives in the back.
Your brother Ben made a right smart living from it. Gonna do the same thing for you, Duke.
I figured life owes me more than just a living. All I want from that bar is for somebody to buy it. Look, I'm gonna be stuck here for 2 months. You really wanna help me?
Sure, Duke.
Then you find me that buyer for the Club Alabama so I can get the hell out of here. Okay?
Sure do.
You take care.
Mr. Duke? Mr. Duke, sir? Is it all right if we walk a piece with you?
We thought you were cool. A wise dude like you. Shows how wrong you can be.
Stevie, you speak for yourself.
Something bothering you, too?
Oh, no, Duke. Everything is exuberant. Except that it's going to be a little hard to find a buyer for the club with that clothes sign on the door.
That's the way it is, bro.
But it don't have to be.
Really? Duke, if the joint was open and people be having fun and partying real good and catching good, well, a sucker come in there then want to buy the joint, you know you're going to have to get down with some heavy bread.
And you could be playing sweet music on the cash register.
You guys are dreaming, man.
Hey, Duke, why do you think those tourist dudes come over here from across the river? It's because they know they can swing to broad daylight. Shh. Get 4 or 5 times what you're asking if the club was open.
And don't forget all those Army reservers over at the Armory. One night a week, after marching and drilling, they're hot and they're thirsty. And what are they here for? The Club Alabama. For some relaxation.
Relaxation, huh? You know something, little man? You remind me of me when I was your age, trying to be somebody, always jiving and hustling.
I ain't hustling. I'm just trying to go up fast in a fast town.
And me? I ain't nothing but an old football player, Duke. Maybe drink too much every now and then. But if you open that club, it sure would make me feel like I was somebody.
Opening the club can't hurt, can it?
You said yourself you're stuck here. So you ain't got nothing to lose, do you?
Do you?
I ain't some dumb broad. I got rights.
Honey, we told you before, don't rip off the marks. It's bad for business.
It ain't fair you making me spend time in this goddamn hole.
We got to think of Bucktown's reputation, honey. You keep clipping the tourists and pretty soon none of them will be coming across the river no more.
But that freaky bastard wanted to wear my underwear.
This place got a chief?
You got an appointment?
No.
What's the matter, boy? Somebody pick your pocket?
I'm here about the clothes sign on the Club Alabama.
Oh, you must be Ben's brother. Everybody liked Ben. He was real people, wasn't he, Merle?
Sure was. Good citizen Ben. Well, that's mighty nice of you fellas to say that. Now, what about that clothes sign?
No problem. All you gotta do is take out a city license.
That's right. How much is that?
How much was that, Merle, for a city sticker? It was $400, wasn't it?
It was more like $450, I thought.
Damned if you're not right.
I'll make sure they get your message.
Do that, Dwayne. You just do that.
You the main man?
Yeah.
You know, just a damn minute.
You're the one I want to talk to.
Duke Johnson?
Yeah.
Come in.
You're not much for manners, are you?
I give what I get.
This what you want? However, nothing is for nothing.
I guess those two crackers out front were serious, huh?
Sam!
Yes, sir?
What's the charge for a city sticker?
450 good old American green.
Not one drop is poured in this town unless each bottle has a city sticker. And the sticker comes from this office. Now, Ben's renewal fee was due 2 days after he died, so now it's overdue.
What happens if it isn't paid?
Place stays padlocked.
And if I decide to sell it?
When I see some dollars on this desk, you can do whatever you like with that flea trap. I like dealing with a reasonable man.
I'd like to get that up and he ditched Ruthie alone. I'll teach you some manners. She always did think she was hot shit.
Just got a bug up your ass.
You got it? Get it out, get it out. It's gonna be five next week, you understand that, boy? Shit. Come on, lover boy, let's go.
Woodrow. Woo! Ha ha, sweetness. Leo, here I
was my favorite. I'm pleased to make the announcement that the Club of Alabama is now open.
No.
Yeah, it is.
So how long is he going to stay?
Well, that ain't important.
Huh. That's what you think. He only did it so he could sell it for a better price.
No. He listened when I told him how good business was going to be and everything.
Just bait to hook the fish that's going to buy it.
Why you got to be so cold? Every time I mention Duke's name, you gotta put him down.
Cause he's just another big city jive-ass spook, that's why. Forget him.
But this is Ben's brother. He deserves a break.
Harley, listen. I've met 100 guys just like him. Take us every goddamn one of them, and I got the scars to prove it.
Oh, shit. You don't know him. This is a different kind of man.
Harley, there ain't no different kind of man.
Hey, y'all, Clint, Sam. Hey, I'm telling you, they ain't no one like that Cleo of mine.
Man, she has got a mouth soft and sweet as an overripe plum. And I'll tell you, that tongue, sweet Jesus.
Shit. If you weren't the chief's cousin, she wouldn't give you a smile for free.
Ain't that the truth?
You go to hell.
Hey, the dude's up in the Alabama. You think it's time Mr. Johnson joined the club?
Yeah, you go on with Sam. Me and Merle got some business.
Oh, come on, Cleek. Let me go with you. I always miss out on all the fun.
Leave this one for the men.
Get in the car, Warren.
Damn!
That tastes like that been flushed down a toilet.
What do you think, Cleve?
Well, if you, smell and look like a pig, I guess you gotta act like one, don't you? All right, fellas, get out.
You want me to tell him, Cleve?
No, I'll tell him, bro. Fact is, I'm gonna tell him real friendly. I'm even gonna call him by his first name.
Nigga, you wanna do business in Bucktown, you gotta pay for the privilege.
Well, you see, I've already paid.
Hey. That was just to take down the sign.
Hey, hey, hey! Everybody do their thing!
Every Saturday night, you come up with $100. Come Saturday, you don't give me my Saturday money. I'm gonna slap a sign on that door. That sign gonna say, nigga, read and run. You can't read and run anyway. First nigga touch that sign, first nigga try to come through that door, I'm gonna kick his head till his eyes pooch out like an eagle's ass and the power dies. You understand what I'm talking about, boy?
Oh, yeah, I understand. It's that cheap, smelly, funky cigar you smoking that's making you talk so funny.
This boy has a mouth.
Alligator mouth and a hummingbird ass. Just like his old brother Ben.
He sure is stubborn like him.
Yeah, don't kick this boy in the head, Merrill. You know you can't hurt them niggas when you kick him in the head.
All right, clowns. You've had your laughs. Now either go out the door or through it. Your choice.
Step aside, boy. I'm checking that cash register.
The price you have to pay to do that, cracker, ain't worth it.
Why you pale faces always together? You faggots!
Oh, you little shit.
Something. You two are a couple of real sweethearts.
What kind of job are you talking about?
Why wasn't I told about what's coming down here?
Oh, Duke, I'm sorry about that. I didn't say nothing because I didn't want you to leave. Aretha here, she figured you were gonna go anyway, so why should she say anything? That's all that went down, man.
Cops throwing on the whole goddamn town, dealing in payoffs, and you don't tell me nothing about it?
I'm sorry about that, Duke.
No, you're not sorry, Harley. Well, what do you expect us to do? We have to live here.
Okay. You two can eat the crap that they dish out, but not me, baby. No way.
Oh, now, wait a minute, dude. do?
Oh, shoot, Harley.
Damn.
Hey!
Now you get this. And you get it straight. I ain't paying off anybody. Not your flunkies, not you, nobody!
Now settle down, Mr. Johnson. Settle down. Now, what do you mean?
Now you can just can the bull. $450 was my first and last payment, Trump!
You may not believe this. We run a pretty busy department here. Public service takes money, and we don't get it all from writing parking tickets, you know. Now, we're not a big town like where you're from, but we have plenty of work to keep us busy. For example, take your brother's case. We're not giving up.
What do you mean, you're not giving up?
Oh, I thought you knew. Some unknown assailant beat him and left him for dead.
I was told he died of natural causes, pneumonia.
True. Due to exposure and loss of blood. Naturally, we did what we could, but... Mr. Johnson, you look to me to be an intelligent man. You've been around, you know the ropes. And you know, a smart man always avoids trouble, tries to get along. Doesn't he, Mr. Johnson?
It's a little warm out tonight, and I thought you might want this.
Come on in.
I haven't gone out of our way to be friends.
It's all right. Forget it. He is looking at you, sweetheart.
This ain't an easy town to live in, you know.
Yeah, what town is?
Well, what I'm trying to say is I was wrong.
Everybody pays the man in this town. Nobody tells me. Hunkies run this town. Nobody tells me. My brother Ben is found dead in the gutter. Nobody tells me how or why.
Well, I'm not proud of the fact that I didn't say nothing. How do you tell somebody that their brother was beaten up by some goons at the police department and left to die in the freezing rain? I wanted to tell you, but...
But you gotta hustle just for a living, right? And you wanna play it safe.
Play it safe? You damn right I play it safe. I'm tired of leading the charge.
You ever heard of pride? You want to go through life being trampled, baby, that's your business.
Well, what do you know about scuffling and hustling and breaking your back for peanuts and taking it all, but still going on living and hoping and dreaming? What the hell do you know about that?
You think you got a monopoly on hard times? I mean, who promised you a free ride?
Well, you think you're really something, don't you? The super successful young brother. Everyone kowtowing to you. Ben told us all about you until we were sick of hearing it. I must be some kind of simple-headed fool for coming in here and trying to apologize to you. For misjudging you, thinking you were just some kind of big city dude coming down here to parade in front of us small town folk.
Now you think different, huh?
Well, I saw different. I saw you stand up for your rights and show that you were your own man. And what do I get for it? Just dumped on.
What do you want from me? My blessing? Or the keys to the city?
You bastard!
Thank you.
your black ass out of town, nigga! Go get him, Merle!
Wouldn't it?
Nothing to it.
Hell, what's one dead nigger more or less?
Now, that's just the point, boys. After Ben, people might get too curious, especially up in the Capitol, and we don't want that. I just wanted him taught a little lesson. We'll see how well he's learned it.
Right, sir.
Get off the car.
You all right, baby?
Yeah, but Duke, you gotta run. They're gonna kill you.
I never ran from nobody, and I don't intend to start now.
But Duke, you can't do it by yourself. Please, Duke, you gotta run. Please.
No chance, baby.
Ease up.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Duke! Duke! Oh, man, where you been? Listen, man. Everybody's been saying, where's Duke? When's he coming home? Yeah.
Listen, I got two or three very sweet propositions waiting for us when you return.
Like always, huh? Listen to one of them here.
Boy, man, I didn't call you up to jive with your brother. We gotta talk serious business, man.
All right. I mean, what's the matter, man? Don't you laugh anymore?
Look, focus in on Detroit. You remember?
Hey, you kidding? We were outnumber what? 3-4-1? Man, you were something else.
Well, the odds here are a lot longer, man. It's a jive town with a bunch of crackers. I need your help.
You really are serious. Excuse me. When?
Yesterday, brother, yesterday.
Well, I owe you one, buddy. I'm on my way.
Roy. Bring muscle.
I'm looking at a dead man.
I take a taxi or a stagecoach.
Cabs broke down.
Figures.
my hat.
Kind of sloppy there, boy.
I've seen better looking places than the slams.
Roy, what does this cat do got on you anyhow?
Hey, fresh meat, what you need? Gambling? Girls?
Back off, little kid.
You name it. Poker? Pinochle? Pool chain?
Fast fight, didn't I tell you the hard way?
Jay, he's just trying to make his hustle.
I started like that too.
Coming,
hey,
man.
What can I do?
Hey, Harley, remember the dude I was telling you about, man? This is him, Roy.
How you doing, Mr. Roy?
Harley.
Oh, this is Aretha. Roy?
Aretha.
Hi, Roy.
Oh, excuse me. This is Josh Hambone, TJ.
How you doing, fellas?
Man, I have never seen anything like this at home.
Me and this cat, we practically grew up together.
Went through some real, real scenes. From the streets all the way up to the top, huh?
Yeah, right on, right on. But good times, right?
Good times. Come on, let's have a drink.
Right.
Man, you really a sight. I don't know what trouble you got, but we're here with the kill.
I like these little cutie pies.
Man, are you crazy? Get rid of this jail, babe.
Sorry, girls. We'll think about the party later.
Come on, we gotta take care of some business. Get your act together.
Yeah.
Okay. So four cops and the chief. That's five. Now what about the guy who hired him, His Honor the Mayor?
No, you won't have to worry about him. He brought the chief in to clean up the town for the tourists.
Afterwards, he saw he had a good thing going, moved right in. Mm-hmm.
So he'd be the happiest of anybody to see him run out of town.
Then we don't have any problem, do we?
Remember that little situation we had a couple of years ago?
You want to work it the same way?
Well, why not, man? No sense in dragging it out. Besides, I want to see if you slowed down in your old age.
Huh. No way.
Hey, there's another one out there now.
Man, this cat's gonna go blind, squinting up at me with his big blue eyes. Duke, what about the boss of these tin soldiers?
Well, as far as I can tell, man, he's all spit and polish. Still think World War II was going on. But I wouldn't pay him too cheap, man. He didn't get this far being dumb.
You wanna chill him first?
No, we'll hook that up after we get the locations.
You sick animal!
What the hell's wrong with her?
I haven't budged for 4 hours.
Nobody stays in that hotel that long.
Where's Dwayne?
He's over there. They're trouble, Brian. They don't look right.
You worry too much, Sam. No coon looks good to a decent man. Just remember, we're the law. And God is on our side.
Yes, sir.
See you later, Sam.
Gets off work after midnight. Usually makes a beeline straight for this place. That's this old lady dancing up there. Usually takes her home about 2 o'clock.
That'd be a good time to nail his ass. In the sack.
Man, you got a mean streak in you, brother.
To the bone.
Hey, like you babies want a little action?
We got each other, Mama.
excuse me, sir. My name is Roy Williams. This is Duke Johnson. I'm sure you know him. He's a friend of mine. We were just taking a little stroll down the street here. We would very much like it if you would join us, huh? No, thanks. I don't smoke.
Think we should ditch him?
No, he's fat enough. Let him get some exercise.
You're a little nod here. Yeah.
Sam likes to spend evenings over at the hotel. There's always a big money game going on. He gets a piece of the take.
Bet five, you want to call?
Then there's Merle. Lives over at Ruby's Whorehouse. Owns a chunk of it. That mother. I mean, that Merle boy, he gets his kicks leaning heavy on the ladies.
How many times have I told you not to be late?
I swear I wasn't honest.
Don't you never lie to me, you hear? Never!
Usually this time of night, there's only one cop man in the fort.
Oh, yeah? Well, there's no sweat, huh? He's probably sleeping on the job. Maybe we ought to try to make it permanent.
Permanent? Damn, brother, you have become one violent dude.
True.
Lover of all mankind, right? Well, the way I see it, man, the first thing we gotta do is take their radio out.
True. Last thing we need is state police snooping around. Somehow, I don't think they'd understand.
Well, what you think, home?
It's cool. Like stealing candy from a baby.
Oh, yeah.
Honey, where are the cigarettes?
They're on the dresser, baby. Fire escape.
Listen, you dumb Sambo, I'm gonna explain it just once more. I don't want my hamburgers without mustard. I want them without ketchup, but with mustard. Now get it right this time, or I'm gonna kick your ass.
Not an inch.
Don't move an inch. You know any prayers, Cracker? Well, shame on you if you don't.
7-8, stand by.
I had to catch it.
Here, I got one.
Where's
another
one? Going in with
give me a raise,
man.
Come on.
Keep my money. I want him. Drop it, gun down, or I'll blow her head off. Drop it.
Duke.
I mean it. Now back up. Back up and let me out of here. I'm going out and I'm taking her with me. Move back. Move back. I'll blow her head off. You stay back. You stay far back. You hear?
Must be losing my touch.
Got to hit him where it hurts, my man.
That's a good shot.
No use wasting good ammo.
And shine, Chief.
The war is over.
Company!
Well, well. Bucktown's own private 10 soldier.
What do you think, Duke?
Well, how about 10 in the morning?
Well, that's too early.
Well, how about high noon?
But then spoil our lunch?
Well, damn, let's shoot him at 1 o'clock then.
How about right now? You're not gonna kill me. News travels fast, it's bound to get to the state troopers. If they ask any questions, you're gonna tell your black mayor to tell them that you're holding the chief of police for breaking the law. Now, you're gonna keep me alive. Because I'm going to keep your black asses from burning in hell.
$1,432, prostitution.
I can't tell you how much we appreciate what you boys have done for our little old town. We were all being,
The word screwed, Mr. Mayor.
Exactly. Just the right word.
Excuse me, sister.
$2,848, gambling.
Before I forget, the badges from your used-to-be police department.
We do thank you. If only there was some way to thank you. I mean, for our town to express our appreciation for what you've done before you leave.
Think real hard. You'll come up with something.
Mr. Mayor? Last night's receipts come to a total of $6,319.
Fine. A parade.
What?
Down the main street with the high school marching band and our pom-pom girls and baton twirlers and you and your boys waving and smiling. And bringing up the rear, the Buchanan Volunteer Fire Department.
No parade.
No parade.
No
No parade?
No, no parades. I think I can suggest a better way for you to show your appreciation, Mr. Mayor.
Duke, Duke, wake up. Get your buns up. Duke. Get up.
Come on, all right, come on. It's anytime's the right time. Come on.
Duke, I didn't come here to get in your bed. I came to get you out of it.
Out of it? Too early. Roy don't leave till 12.
But Duke, that's what I came here to tell you. The train's leaving, but Roy ain't. Duke.
Roy, what are you talking about?
They're all staying here.
Now what are they gonna do in this hick town?
They're gonna wear badges in this hick town.
Badges?
Roy Conn, the mayor. Now he's wearing the chief's badge. Josh, TJ, and Hamburg are policemen.
I'll be damned. All four of them, huh? And all of them with a rap sheet a yard long. And you know that old Roy's really up to something.
Well, that's not hard to figure out. You want my opinion?
No.
Well, you're gonna get it anyway, dummy. Your buddy saw what a good thing the chief had going for him, and now he wants it for himself.
No, they're brothers. The chief and his boys, they were...
honkies. Well, let me tell you something about people, Big Shot. Whether they're white, black, green, yellow, or purple, when they smell a few dollars, they all act alike. Mm. Get up!
I won't tell you anything. Bugtown's pure gold, Chief. And you've been squeezing and milking it dry. So come on. For the last time, where's the dough?
Paying off street scum is easy. Giving in to them. Impossible.
A man who won't talk doesn't need his tongue. Hambone. Hey, partner. Welcome to the promised land, huh?
Hey, baby, why don't you go and put something on a little sweeter, huh? From a man.
Sure.
What is it, we're gonna be partners in, buddy? I thought you were gonna leave town, man. What happened?
Considerable. Considerable. Man, listen, when I got the telephone call back in Philly that my partner needed some help, how was I to know that he was going to cut me in on a soft touch that I'd been waiting for all my life?
A touch? What are you talking about, man? I just called you in this town to help me get rid of some jive crackers, that's all.
All right, all right. So you know what the good book says. The Lord helps them that helps themselves. And that's what we're doing, man. We're helping ourselves. We own this town. And thanks to his honor, we even got the badges here to prove it. Huh? Here's yours.
No, man. That's not my way, Roy.
What's the matter, man? Huh? You don't like money? Or are you beginning to fall for this small town jive? I mean, here we got a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, and my homeboy's going soft on me.
Oh, come on, Roy. You know better than that.
Why do I know? How do I know? You don't even act like the cat I grew up with.
Man, it's just that this is my brother's town, man. His friends. I mean, I wouldn't feel right leaning on his people, man.
Okay. If that's the way you want it, that's the way it'll be. Now, I'll tell you what. I won't lean on them too hard, just enough to pay the rent. Yeah. Like Robin Hood. Rob from the rich, give to the poor. But you just keep running that little club of yours down there, see? And we'll take your share of the money and put it in the safe down at City Hall. And when you decide you want it, it'll be there waiting for you.
You're serious, ain't you?
I'm serious as a heart attack.
Oh, man, I ain't gonna be no more trouble than the tax collector. Come on, brother, aren't you? We supposed to be friends, man. Come all this way to help you out? Come on. Hey. A toast, huh? To beautiful Bucktown.
$300 short.
Last night was lousy.
You know what Roy said.
How the hell can I come up with an extra 50% when the girls didn't even make it?
Well, just open your piggy bank, baby. Everybody's got to come up with the new dudes. New day.
Man, this town is something else. Like every night is bank night, you know. The town clipping the tourists and us clipping the town.
It's just one thing wrong. Roy's friend.
Are you talking about Duke?
Yeah. And he's got a big hand in the money. He doesn't do a damn thing to help us earn it.
Well, nothing we can do, because that's the way Roy wants it.
Well, maybe there is. I mean, they're good buddies, right? Mm-hmm. And what said they weren't such good buddies? Then we could step in and do something.
Listen, TJ, no two dudes ever been closer. So how could we change anything?
Man, I already got something going. Josh working right now. But see, you and I gotta give him a hand. Then I'll show you how to change things, all right?
All right.
All right.
All right. I'm gonna try to explain it to your satisfaction. Now, the quarterback come up to the line of scrimmage. He see the whole covering on the right, so he called the covering color, which is green. Singles was 38, 45, and number 4 was the right halfback coming over the right hole. And number 5 is mine, because I'm the only one somebody can take out 2 men.
Harley here keeps telling me he threw that key block in the championship game. Expects me to believe him.
Big lying nuisance. Big phony.
Yeah, Mama's a nuisance. She the biggest nuisance you ever met.
I say you're lying, big man.
I ain't lying, punk. And you, punk. And you a sissy. And you, son of a gun, you a punk and a sissy.
Lying lush. I say you're lying lush.
Big star football player.
I tell you, I was a star of that game, motherfucker.
If business gets any better, we're gonna need a bigger safe. Listen, add this up right here.
Now, Roy.
What are you waiting for?
For you to tell me why you sent your goons to beat up on Harley.
Why would I do a thing like that?
Listen, Harlot is in the hospital, man, and if you don't make it...
Oh, come on, man. Cool it. Cool it. I mean, you're making a lot to do out of nothing. The way I get it, Harlot was getting drunk in the bar, right? It's causing a disturbance. That was a complaint. What are my men wearing those badges for except to keep the peace?
Oh, come on, Roy. You know that's BS.
Calling me a liar?
No, man, I'm not calling you a lie. I'm just trying to find out the truth.
So am I. What's wrong, Duke? I mean, what's happening? I mean, after all we've been through, man, why would I want to lay our friendship on the line behind some bullshit?
I'm not coming down on you, Roy. I just want you to control your clowns, that's all, because if they push my people around again, they're gonna have to tangle with me. That's all I'm saying, man.
Okay. All right. What did happen to Harley?
I mean, like I told you, big man can't handle the sauce. We went in to make an arrest, and he began throwing his weight around. So it took three of us to get him out.
That's all.
Would I lie to you?
Harley, how does your father feel?
All right.
Well, what happened? I know you didn't start that fight like they said you did.
I don't rightly remember, Marie. I do know we was all in the bar there drinking. I was telling them how I was the star. The game. They said I was lying. They say it took 45 stitches to sew me up. That's some kind of record, ain't it?
Yeah, Harley, that's some kind of record.
I'm sorry, Rita. I feel like a stomped-out fool.
Oh, Harley. No, you my number one.
It's like your friend Roy is building up an army.
Poor old Bucktown. Things are bad enough under the old chief, but now...
they're 10 times worse. There's no way that we can fire them. No way. No way.
Can I buy you a drink, lady?
Suit yourself.
Two of the same. Where's your man?
Not here. He's at the hospital looking in on Harley.
How is Harley?
He's making it. No thanks to you.
Thank you. Maybe you could do yourself and your man a big favor if you would.
Like how?
Get him to leave town now.
Why should he leave town?
Well, there are a lot of big reasons down that vault at City Hall. His cut of the pie. You two could live real high on his share of the money. Huh? Fine diamonds, jewelry, high living.
Suppose I want to stay.
Well, you got a pretty nice choice any way you look at it. If you go, you got Duke and all that heavy bread. And if you decide to stay on here in Bucktown, I'd be willing to make you a very sweet proposition. Seriously.
What if we both decide to stay? Me and Duke.
I don't think that'd be too pleasant.
Now, you're going about it the wrong way, TJ.
Oh, man.
You could think Roy set it all up.
You wait here.
First, I'm gonna break your arms. And I'm gonna break your legs. I'm gonna start on your face.
Baby, I thought we're your friends. Now we come down here to help you out.
Yeah, Josh, you can help. You get this idiot out of here before I blow his brains out.
Wait a minute, man. Wait a minute. What's wrong?
Sit down. I want your full attention.
All right, man. You got it.
I called you here to do me a favor. And you take over the whole goddamn town. You had bright ideas right from the start, didn't you, old buddy? And I fell for all that crap about you, not leaning hard on the town. But it's worse now than it ever was, man, because now his brother's doing it. So what good did he do bringing you here in the first place?
Well, go on, man. Don't stop talking. I'm listening.
You send your punks to beat Harley up. Then you send them after Aretha.
I did what?
Listen, because I'm only going to say it once, Roy. I want your punks gone, out of town. Oh, I swear, man, I'll plant them in their own stink.
Let me tell you something. Ever since we helped you get rid of that chief and them goddamn rednecks, you've been acting like a goddamn fool. You won't do this, you won't do that, you won't even take any of the money we're trying to give you. And now you're busting my place and accuse me of pulling all kind of weird shit. Well, I am tired.
tired of it. And I ain't gonna stand for no more of it. Now, just get this. Get this in that head of yours. I am running this town. I'm running it. And I got the mayor and everybody else right by the balls, including you. And if anybody's gonna leave, it ain't gonna be old Roy. It's gonna be you. You dig?
That's the way it is, huh?
You called it.
All right, buddy. All bets are off.
Give me the police department. TJ, this is Roy. You wanted me to set an example for this town. From now on, everybody pays. So lean on him.
Everybody have a drink and beat somebody. Make goddamn sure you pay for it. Look, we got some white people in the joint. You guys have a good time. All right? What's going on?
Hey, really fast.
Jasper, sure it's good to be home, boy. Hey, Rita. How you doing?
The doctor said you're supposed to be resting.
Ah, shit, I'm tired. Listen, I want to be here with my friend.
Right on, man. All right, I'm not going to argue about it.
Say, where's the Duke?
He's taking care of business.
Big shot.
Yeah, yeah.
We came early. TJ?
Yeah.
Josh?
Hello?
We got a special message for him.
Go get word to Duke.
Where is he?
Show him what we're talking about, TJ. Takes one little match.
You bastard!
You crazy motherfucker!
Imagine that. Assaulting the lawman. Take him in.
Somebody see me. Don't let
me in. I'll ask you get him soon enough.
She needs you.
How many out front?
One.
Hey, kid. Hold it.
Thank God you're here.
What's happened here?
Roy's
three hoods came in here and they tried to burn the place down. Harley tried to stop him and they dragged him off.
Drug him where?
To jail. You gotta talk to Roy. Make him let Harley go. Roy's your friend.
No, he's gone too far now. It's too late to talk.
No, you can't fight him alone. There'll be five or six of them at the jail.
I got a plan that should even up the odds a little bit.
But Duke, what good is it gonna do, Harley, getting yourself killed? Duke!
Steve, you know that armor you was telling me about across the river? You know where it is?
Yeah, I can find it.
Come on, let's go.
Roy, I want to talk to you. Please, Roy, it's important.
Roy, I'm listening.
I'm asking you to let Harley go. It wasn't his fault. He just got a little crazy when your boys came in the bar and tried to burn it down.
Well, maybe you ought to blame Duke for that, not me.
Well, don't take it out on Harley because of your feelings for Duke.
Well, since you're pointing fingers for what happened, woman, it wasn't my choice. It was his. I mean, Duke's got his head in a weird kind of place.
No, no, he does not want to go against you. He says you're his friend.
Yeah, but we've been tight. But that comes with respect. And respect comes from knowing how it is in the streets. What you have to do to get by and doing it well, damn well, that's what it's all about.
But it doesn't make any sense. It's just your damn ego.
Ego? No. It's how you survive.
Well, I want Duke to survive. I want to love that man. I don't want to bury him. You just don't give a damn about anybody, do you?
You listen to me. You show me anybody who gives a damn about anybody else, and I'll show you a fool. A damn fool who go through life with their hands out begging instead of grabbing. Do you think anybody in this town is any different? They don't give a damn who gets killed, just so long as the dice keep rolling, the hoes keep hoeing, and the money keeps flowing. It all revolves around the big G, baby, the big green. Everybody everywhere is scratching for what they can get. I'm just scratching a little harder.
You poor, selfish, ignorant man. Haven't you ever had the guts to love somebody else?
Maybe. Maybe I never had a woman like you to fight for me. Maybe I even envy Duke for that. I'll be seeing you.
That monster could open up the gates of hell.
Well, what can I do for you?
Where's TJ? TJ, I want to talk to you.
Well, I haven't been
been too friendly with you, and I thought I'd come by and apologize.
Is that right?
Yes, that's right. And I need a favor.
What do you cost?
Well, you do me this one little old favor, and I'll do anything you want, and some.
Like what?
Harley. He's just an old drunk that I feel sorry for. He's no good to anybody. Let him go.
All right. Have it your way. After,
Before. You let him go now, and it'll be good between you and me all the way.
Okay. We do it your way. Follow me.
Place for a woman.
Shh. I came to keep Duke from getting
Duke.
Shh.
Shh.
Would you please let him go now? I gotta get him to a doctor.
Dumb broad. You come in trying to deal. I don't make no deals. I take what I want. And then I'm gonna kill Duke. It's like this. Now, where's all that honey you coming from? That sugar and milk.
Boy, bag! Bag!
I'm a bag.
I don't beg for nothing.
You want more? Tighten up, nigga. Now, bag! Bag!
No!
Bag! Now you freeze, nigga.
Harley. You all right, dude?
Yes.
Where's the ammo?
In the chariot.
Get them all.
All except one.
I always knew my buddy was a real man.
If anybody had told me, Roy, that we would be on opposite sides fighting each other.
You might not believe this, but I never lied to you. I never sent anyone to hassle Harley or Aretha.
How did it happen then, Roy?
TJ, he wanted us to tangle.
Looks like he did a good job, didn't he? It's down to me and you now, right? I don't want to shoot you, Roy. I just want to beat the hell out of you.
It's your deal.
Winner take all. Loser, get out of town. Never look back. Deal?
Deal.
Thank you. A little bit. Besides, you and I gotta go home and get some sleep so we can get up and go to school tomorrow.
School?
That's right. Don't you want to grow up to be somebody?
I am.
What?
Oh, man.
Don't care,
man.
Since I'm here, I'll get mine. Woman over there, mighty fine. She's always on my mind. Things are getting better in Bucktown. I see the people laying their money down. Things are getting better in Bucktown. I think I'm gonna hang around. Getting better in Bucktown. I see the people laying their money down. With no warning, I walk right in on a shaft without a hole on the town. It might take a tank to lift in the grip. I might have to tear it down. I ain't come for a good time. Since I'm here, I'll get mine. Woman over there is mighty fine. She's always on my mind. Things are getting better in Bucktown. I see the people laying their money down. Things are getting better in Bucktown. I think I'm gonna